Whether we like it or not, our obsession with courtship seems to take center stage. Outside of a geeky entomology laboratory, it is quite rare for a discussion about courtship to include any mention of mosquitoes, as the vast majority of species don't display any behavioral patterns complex enough to even qualify for the term. For most mosquitoes, mating is a fast and haphazard occurrence with swarms of males circling around and waiting for the sound of female wing beats. Once detected, the male rushes after the female and immediately attempts copulation mid-air without so much as a how do you do. And this is not courtship. There is one notable exception, the paddle-legged beauty, Sabathis cyanus. Found in Central and South America, this tropical forest species lay their eggs in shaded natural and artificial containers, such as tree holes, bamboo hollows, and even fallen banana leaves filled with rainwater. Sabathis larvae develop in these small source pools and feed on bacteria, algae, and other organic material. The beautiful adult Sabathis mosquitoes are usually encountered in close proximity to the small habitats of their youth. Few people would use the words beautiful and mosquito in the same sentence, but Sabathis cyanus has few rivals when it comes to looks. Its color is predominantly a stunning iridescent blue, marked with contrasting silvery white spots, especially on the abdomen. Bold colors are not their only unique feature. The feather-like paddles catch the eye as well. Formed by elongated scales, located on the tibia of each middle leg, both the male and female sport these strange paddles. The function of the paddles is not fully understood. However, in the late 1980s, Dr. Robert Hancock and his colleagues observed mating behaviors that may lead to a better understanding. Hancock's team described the unique and elaborate series of stereotypical behaviors displayed by Sabathis mosquitoes prior to and during mating. Although dinner and dancing is not required as part of the ritual, the males must go through a number of displays and movements in a specific order, and the female has multiple opportunities to accept or reject his advances. The wooing begins with the female resting on the underside of a horizontal surface, such as a stick or twig. The male, apparently attracted by her stunning beauty, hovers around the female with his leg paddles outstretched. He then places one of these middle legs over her wing, perhaps preventing her from just flying away, but also to be used as a pivot point as he swings around to face his date and simultaneously grasps the twig with his front legs. Once aligned, the true courtship begins. The male waves his free mid-leg back and forth, apparently showing off his lovely paddle, but eliciting no apparent response from the female. Next, the male will flex his forelegs to create a bout of rhythmic body swinging while simultaneously flicking his proboscis downward. If successful, this display will induce the female to lower her abdomen sufficiently for copulation to take place. If unsuccessful, he would return to waving his free midleg, followed by another round of rhythmic body swinging, until she either lowers her abdomen or uses her hind legs to eject him by pushing him away. During mating, the male gyrates his abdomen while waving his middle and hind legs alternately until mating is completed and the pair disengages. So, in regards to mating, how important are those feather-like paddles? Hancock and his colleagues did some experiments to find out, removing the paddles and observing the results. If removed from the female, the males rarely approached. Apparently, for females, the paddles serve to attract the males. However, if the paddles were removed from the male legs, the males approached females to court with the same levels of success. What specific functions these paddles serve on the males remains unknown.